I welcome you all to the 27th Professor G. Ramareddy Memorial Lecture. For the unversed, let me tell you that every year on 2nd of July, we organize this lecture series to remember very fondly our beloved and revered Founder Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Ramareddy. On this day, we pay homage to this visionary and legendary educationist by inviting eminent speakers from varied and diverse fields to enrich and enlighten our academic pursuits. In the line, we have invited Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh, Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs and Education, Government of India. Very soon, he'll be with us, and we will begin the formal proceedings of the program.
Namaskar. Pratyek varsh 2 July ko hum apne priya aur sammanit इग्नू के सर्वप्रथम कुलपति प्रोफेसर जी राम रेड्डी जी को अत्यंत प्रेम और श्रद्धा के साथ याद करते हैं. उनकी स्मृति में एक विशिष्ट व्याख्यान का आयोजन करते हैं. इस दिन हम अपनी अकादमिक गतिविधियों को और अधिक समृद्ध करने हेतु विविध क्षेत्रों के प्रख्यात और विद्वान वक्ताओं को आमंत्रित करके इस दूरदर्शी और महान शिक्षाविद को अपनी श्रद्धांजलि अर्पित करते हैं. इसी क्रम में आज के विशेष व्याख्यान का विषय है भारतीय शिक्षा प्रणाली की यात्रा में भारत की आज़ादी के 75 साल. इस विषय पर अपना वक्तव्य देने हेतु हमारे मध्य समुपस्थित होंगे आज के इस कार्यक्रम के मुख्य अतिथि परमादरणीय डॉक्टर राजकुमार रंजन सिंह जी, माननीय विदेश एवं शिक्षा राज्य मंत्री भारत सरकार. ॐ स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति न पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तारक्षयो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु. ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभिः शृणुयाम देवा भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभियज्जत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागुंसस्तनुर्भिर्वयशेमहि देवहितं यदायुः.
I welcome all the dignitaries present with us today. Our esteemed speaker of the day, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh, Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs and Education, Government of India, our very own Srimati Pramila Reddy ma'am. May I please request you, ma'am, to come up the dais. I welcome Honorable Vice Chancellor of Indira Gandhi National Open University, respected Pro Vice Chancellors of the university sitting on the dais and off the dais, Professor R.P. Das sir, Professor Satyakam sir, who is also the chairman of the organizing committee of today's program, Professor Uma Kanjilal ma'am, Professor Sumitra Kukreti ma'am, Dr. Srikant Mahapatra, Dr. Manroop Singh Meena, and Registrar IGNU, Dr. Alok Chaube. I also extend warm welcome to all the directors of the schools, heads of the centers and divisions, our colleagues at headquarters as well as at regional centers, and all our learners and viewers who have joined us today through various online platforms such as Gyan Darshan, Gyanvani, Gyandhara, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, etc. Professor G. Ramareddy, a legendary educationist, a great leader, a distinguished scholar, and an epitome of knowledge, foresaw, planned, designed, and shaped the academic and administrative setup of our mega university, which is now making a mark worldwide under the adept guidance of our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Nageshwar Rao sir. Before we begin the proceedings of today's program, may I request Team Electronic Media Production Center to play our university's Kulgeet, please?
Aap sabhi se anurodh hai ki Kulgeet prasaran ke dauran kripya apne sthan par khade rahe.
शिक्षा का आलय जन जन का विश्वविद्यालय जन जन का हमारे वंचितों को शिक्षा के अधिकार की, ना उम्र का कोई बंधन ना बंदिश परिधि की। घर घर है बना शिक्षा का देवालय, यह जन जन का विश्वविद्यालय, जन जन का विश्वविद्यालय,
जन जन का
भूषित नवाचार से सज्जित, गुणवत्ता से परिपूरित, ज्ञान वाणी ज्ञान दर्शन ज्ञान कोश से संचित, ज्ञान कोश से संचित, सर्वगुण संपन्न शिक्षा का हिमालय, शिक्षा का हिमालय,
Let us start this program traditionally by lighting the lamp. May I request the dignitaries on the dais, Srimati and Srimati Pramila Reddy ma'am, and also Ms. Jyoti, to please join Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh sir in lighting the lamp, please.
ॐ भूर्भुवः स्वः, ॐ भूर्भुवस्य द्यौरिव भूम्ना पृथिवीववरिम्ना, तस्यास्ते पृथिवी देवयजनी, पृष्ठे अग्नि मन्नादमन्ना द्यायादधे। ॐ उद्बुद्वस्वाग्ने प्रतिजाग्रही, त्वमिष्टा पूर्ते सगुं सृजे थामयञ्च, अस्मिन् तधस्ते अद्युत्तरस्मिन् विश्वे देवा यजमानश्च सीदत। ॐ स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः, स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः, स्वस्ति नस्तारक्षयो अरिष्टनेमिः, स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु।
I request for floral tribute, please. May I request all the pro vice chancellor sitting off the dais to pay a floral tribute to Professor G. Ramareddy, please. May I now request our respected Pro Vice Chancellor, Professor Satyakam sir, for his welcome address, please.
Namaskar. Aaj ka yeh din hum prativarsh इकट्ठा होते हैं और अपने संस्थापक कुलपति प्रोफेसर राम रेड्डी जी को स्मरण करते हैं और इस दिन हमारे बीच मुख्य अतिथि उपस्थित होते हैं और वे अपने व्याख्यान से हमें लाभान्वित करते हैं। साथियों, आज हमारे बीच उपस्थित हैं डॉक्टर राजकुमार रंजन सिंह जी, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स एंड एजुकेशन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। आपका व्यक्तित्व और आपकी जीवन की जो ऐतिहासिक यात्रा है वह बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण, रोचक और प्रेरणादायी। डॉक्टर राजकुमार रंजन सिंह वॉज बॉर्न इन 1952 एट कोनबंगा नांदी में लेखई इम्फाल ईस्ट मणिपुर। ही ऑब्टेन्ड Master's degree in geography and PhD in problems of land use in the valley of Manipur from Guwahati University. राजनीतिक जीवन में सक्रियता से उपस्थित होने के पूर्व वे एक पर्यावरणविद, प्रसिद्ध भूगर्भ शास्त्री, प्रसिद्ध भौगोलिक और एक ऐसे समाज की चिंता करने वाले व्यक्ति हैं जिन्होंने अपना जीवन तो एक अध्यापक के रूप में, प्रोफेसर के रूप में आरंभ किया और यही नहीं, उन्होंने विश्वविद्यालय में प्रशासनिक पदों को का भी दायित्व निर्वहन किया। इसके बावजूद एक अध्यापक होने के नाते उनमें जो एक संवेदना थी समाज के प्रति, जो एक कल्याणकारी भाव था उनके मन में, तो उन्हें ये लगा कि वे राजनीति में आकर समाज की अधिक सेवा कर सकते हैं। आफ्टर रिटायरमेंट फ्रॉम एक्टिव सर्विस ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी ही टुक हिज प्लंज इनटू इलेक्टोरल पॉलिटिक्स बाय ज्वाइनिंग बीजेपी इन 2014। उसके बाद वे बीजेपी के प्रवक्ता रहे और अध्यक्ष का भी बीजेपी बॉडी ऑन द स्टेट विजन डॉक्यूमेंट के अध्यक्ष रहे, और उसके बाद वहां से जो यात्रा शुरू की थी पीछे मुड़कर कभी नहीं देखा, और अपने इस यात्रा के प्रारंभ करते करते वे 17वीं लोकसभा में इनर मणिपुरी कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी से सांसद के रूप में चुने गए। जनता ने उन्हें चुना, एक ऐतिहासिक विजय मिली उन्हें, और आज हमारे समक्ष वे ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स एंड एजुकेशन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैं। मैं उनका स्वागत करता हूं हृदय से, और अपने सभी उपस्थित महानुभावों से अनुरोध करता हूं कि करतल ध्वनि से उनका स्वागत किया जाए। डॉक्टर राजकुमार सिंह आज हमारे बीच हैं, और मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में, लेकिन महत्वपूर्ण पक्ष यह है कि वे एक ऐसे व्यक्तित्व के बारे में, प्रोफेसर राम रेड्डी, जिन्होंने ये बिरवा लगाया था इस इग्नू का, जो चहुं ओर फैल रहा है, देश में, विदेश में, चारों ओर, दूर दूर तक गांवों में। ये सपना था प्रोफेसर रामा रेड्डी साहब, ये जो मैदानगढ़ी के गांव के बीच में हम हैं, ये उनका ही सपना था कि हमें एक विश्वविद्यालय चाहिए, हमें एक परिसर चाहिए, और इसी पर वक्तव्य देने के लिए आज हमारे बीच उपस्थित हैं माननीय डॉक्टर राजकुमार रंजन सिंह जी। मैं विश्वविद्यालय की ओर से, अपनी ओर से, और पूरे इग्नू फ्रैटर्निटी की ओर से आपका हृदय के की अतल गहराइयों से स्वागत और अभिनंदन करता हूं। हमारे कुलपति प्रोफेसर नागेश्वर राव जी, उनके नेतृत्व में हम लगातार काम करते आ रहे हैं। यहाँ जितने भी लोग मौजूद हैं और जो नहीं भी मौजूद हैं, जो इस विश्वविद्यालय में काम करते हैं या इस विश्वविद्यालय की परिधि के बाहर रहकर जुड़े भी हुए हैं, वे उनकी नेतृत्व क्षमता, उनकी अकादमिक क्षमता और उनकी गहरी सोच से परिचित हैं। मैं अपने विश्वविद्यालय के कुलपति आदरणीय प्रोफेसर नागेश्वर राव जी का भी बहुत स्वागत करता हूं। आज हमारे बीच आदरणीय श्रीमती प्रमिला रेड्डी जी उपस्थित हैं। आज उनकी आंखों से हम अपने स्थापक कुलपति को देख पाते हैं। हम उन्हें देखते हैं तो ऐसा लगता है कि हम आदरणीय प्रोफेसर राम रेड्डी जी को ही देख रहे हैं, और हर बार बिना किसी संकोच के, बिना किसी दुविधा के, जब भी हम उनको बुलाते हैं वे यहाँ आती हैं, अपना आशीर्वाद हमें देती हैं। मैं उनका भी अभिनंदन करता हूँ। अभिनंदन करना या स्वागत करना एक औपचारिकता नहीं है, बल्कि विश्वविद्यालय की ओर से जो हम कृतज्ञता प्रकट करते हैं, उसके लिए मैं अपने कुल सचिव, अपने प्रोवाइस चांसलर साहब और सभी प्रोवाइस चांसलर्स, डायरेक्टर्स, सबका मैं स्वागत और अभिनंदन करता हूं। आप लोग अवकाश के दिन आए, और इसलिए आए कि प्रोफेसर राम रेड्डी जी का नाम आपको खींच लाता है, क्योंकि उन्हीं के कारण आज हम सब हैं, और इसलिए मैं आप लोगों को भी कोटिशः स्वागत करता हूं और आपको धन्यवाद देता हूं कि आप लोग यहां आए। यहाँ जितने भी लोग हैं जो प्रत्यक्ष और परोक्ष रूप से जिन्होंने इस कार्यक्रम को आयोजित करने में मदद की है, चाहे वो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया प्रोडक्शन सेंटर हो, चाहे सिक्योरिटी हो, और तमाम प्रशासनिक और अकादमिक शिक्षक जो इसमें लगे हुए हैं, मैं उनका भी स्वागत करता हूं, क्योंकि उनके बिना ये कार्यक्रम संभव नहीं था। तो एक बार फिर इस कार्यक्रम में आपको आने के लिए बहुत धन्यवाद। हमारे बीच आदरणीय शास्त्री जी भी उपस्थित हैं, मैं आपका भी अभिनंदन और स्वागत करता हूं कि आप हमारे निमंत्रण पर यहां आए, भारतीय भाषा समिति के अध्यक्ष, और जो विदेश से हमारे जो प्रतिनिधिमंडल जो आया हुआ है, उनका भी मैं हृदय की अतल गहराइयों से स्वागत करता हूं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, शुक्रिया।
धन्यवाद सर। अब मैं हमारे माननीय कुलपति महोदय से विनम्र निवेदन करता हूं कि वे मुख्य अतिथि महोदय को अंगवस्त्र, स्मृति चिन्ह और पादपाधानी भेंट कर उनका अभिनंदन करें।
I now request our Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, to felicitate Srimati Pramila Reddy, ma'am.
धन्यवाद सर। अब मैं हमारे आदरणीय समकुलपति डॉक्टर श्रीकांत महापात्रा सर को आज के कार्यक्रम के विषय में अपना वक्तव्य देने हेतु विनम्र निवेदन करता हूं।
नमस्कार। ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर of external affairs and education, government of India, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh ji, Madam Pramila Reddy, our honorable vice chancellor Professor Nageshwar Rao ji, the chairman of the G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture Committee, Organizing Committee Professor Satyakam, Registrar Dr. Alok Chobe ji, Honorable Pro Vice Chancellors Dr. Shastri ji, our distinguished teachers and all members of the IGNO family, I welcome you all to this 27th G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture, which will be delivered by our chief guest, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh ji, on Indian education system in the journey of 75 years of independence of India. This is a memorable day in the history of IGNO. And on this day, on 2nd July, every year, for the last 27 years, we have been remembering our founding Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Ram Reddy. Professor G. Ram Reddy was born in December 1929 in Karimnagar in Andhra Pradesh, now in Telangana. He was a student of political science, did his MA in political science from Osmania University, and he became a lecturer also in Osmania University, his alma mater. And in 1977, he became the 12th vice chancellor of Osmania University. And he had the privilege of having the vice chancellor of Osmania University for two consecutive terms up to 1982. In 1982, he became the founding vice chancellor of Andhra Pradesh Open University. That was the first open university in India, which was subsequently renamed as Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University in Andhra Pradesh. For 3 years, he was the vice chancellor there. And then in 1985, he was called by the government of India to the headquarters in Delhi to prepare a project report on establishment of the National Open University for the country. And in 6 months' time, the project for the National Open University was presented to the government, and from the government to the parliament. And in parliament, the IGNU Act was passed in 1985, and he became the founding vice chancellor of the Indira Gandhi National Open University. And Professor G. Ram Reddy continued his term till 1989. And subsequently, he became the chairman of the University Grants Commission. He became the chairman of the Indian Council of Social Science Research. He was instrumental in the establishment of the National Assessment and Accreditation Council, called NAC. And he was the first vice president of the Commonwealth of Learning, Vancouver, Canada. And suddenly, on 2nd July 1995, the noble soul of Professor G. Ram Reddy departed to the heavenly abode. And as a mark of respect, in memory of the founding vice chancellor, IGNU community decided to every year organize the G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture on 2nd of July, and we started it in 1996, and now it is 2022. That is, consecutively in last 27 years, we have not missed a single year in organizing the G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture in this university. Very distinguished scholars, eminent personalities in the field of education had graced the occasion of G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture celebration, starting from 1996, when the president of the Commonwealth of Learning, Gajraj Dharmarajan, delivered the lecture, and his lecture was on face-to-face with distance education. And the last lecture was delivered by our own former pro-vice-chancellor, acting vice-chancellor, and the former vice-chancellor of B.R. Ambedkar Open University, Hyderabad, and the director of NAC, Professor V.S. Prasad. During the pandemic also, we organized G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture in the virtual mode. Last year it was virtual mode, and this year we are lucky that we are having this meeting in the face-to-face mode. Among all the distinguished scholars who had graced this occasion on 2nd of July, I'll only quote a few names. Professor N.R. Arthanayake, the former vice chancellor of Sri Lanka Open University, who was present in the very first meeting, and he said that it is a misnomer that we call G. Ram Reddy as the founder of two open universities, Ambedkar Open University in Hyderabad and Indira Gandhi National Open University. In fact, he is the architect of three open universities. And the third open university is the Open University of Sri Lanka. And he had a tremendous contribution for the establishment of Open University of Sri Lanka as well. Then Professor Ian Modric, who was the former director of the Commonwealth of Planning, professor, a famous professor of political science, Professor RVR Chandrasekhar Rao, former Vice Chancellor of B.R. Ambedkar Open University, was with us in the year 2000. In 2001, we had Ian MacDonald, who was the chairman of the Commonwealth of Learning, K.S. Kasturi Rangan, who was the chairman of the Indian Space Research Organization, was with us in 2002. In 2003, Dr. R.A. Maslekar, the Director General of the CSIR of Government of India, was with us. Dr. Madhavan Nayar, the Chairman ISRO, was with us in the year 2004. N.R. Madhav Menon, the Director of the National Law Academy, was our next distinguished guest. Professor Yaspal, the former Chairman of UGC, was with us. T. Ramasamy, the Secretary Ministry of Science and Technology, was with us. We had Mantek Singh Aluwalia, the Vice Chairman of the then Planning Commission, had graced the occasion. We have Kiran Karnik, the former President of the NASSCOM. He had also spoken on electronic media and development from this podium. And we had so many other distinguished dignitaries who had graced the G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture. And the Electronic Media Production Center has a wide collection of all the lectures. And every year we prepare a film on G. Ram Reddy to mark the occasion. The Library and Documentation Division of the university has a corner where you get all the press clippings, photographs, writings, speeches of Dr. G. Ram Reddy. We fondly remember this day, and I once again welcome our chief guest, our Honorable Minister, to this grand occasion of the university, memorable day of the university, to deliver his talk on the future of Indian education system in the context of the National Education Policy 2020. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We have a very talented and technically sound team of Electronic Media and Production Center. This center produces a short film every year for this occasion. This year also, they have prepared a film titled Professor G. Ram Reddy, Vision and Mission in Education. May I request Team EMPC to play the film, please?
Distance and open education system is the only approach which can meet the challenge of educational problems. These impactful words by a visionary brought a great revolution in the higher education system of the country. Yes, we are talking about the father of open learning in India, Professor G. Ram Reddy. Professor G. Ram Reddy was born on 4th of December 1929 in the small village of Malaram in the Karim Nagar district of present-day Telangana. He believed in the power of education and dedicated his entire life to what he called democratizing higher education. He overcame all the struggles and challenges to become the first from his village to have passed the matriculation examination. In the year 1949, his determination and dedication led him to the prestigious Nizam College at Hyderabad. He went on to complete his master's in political science, and in 1957, he left for London to study at the prestigious London School of Economics.
When I came back from UK, I should join the private sector. But under the influence of the Labour Party, we felt that we should not serve the private sector. Therefore, I joined as a lecturer. And once I joined as a lecturer, there was no other ambition except to continue in the profession. When you are a lecturer, you want to become a reader. When you are a reader, you want to become a professor. all that, I must say, I've been able to get that these promotions fairly quickly and rapidly. Maybe the society was very generous to me, very kind to me.
Upon his return from London as a young postgraduate, he joined Osmania University as a lecturer in 1959. He soon became a popular teacher among his students and was equally appreciated by his colleagues. In the year 1977, he became the Vice Chancellor of the Osmania University and served the university in that capacity for 2 terms. In the year 1982, this visionary leader gifted the country its first open and distance university, the Andhra Pradesh Open University, which was later renamed as Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University. After seeing the impact and possibilities of the open and distance learning system in educating the huge population of the country, Professor G. Ram Reddy became the obvious choice of the Government of India in formulating and initiating a national open university. Thus, in the year 1985, the Indira Gandhi National Open University was born under his able leadership.
My ambition has been to keep an all-India image of this institution. We have consciously brought people from different parts of the country. This has been done consciously so that it remains an all-India institution, doesn't become a local institution.
IGNU was established by an Act of Parliament with the mandate to reach the unreached by offering high-quality, innovative, flexible and need-based educational programs to all the segments of the society and modern technology-enabled educational system.
Professor Ram Reddy, with his experience in higher education as a Vice Chancellor of Osmania University for 5 years, and associated with many international higher education institutions, he shared the experience of British Open University with the political system in Andhra Pradesh, and political system immediately supported the idea. The establishment of Open University in 1982 is a result of 2 conditions. One is the vision, competence and persuasive abilities and contacts and sincerity of purpose of leader like Professor Ram Reddy.
Professor G. Ram Reddy's efforts were recognized and achievements were appreciated both in India and abroad.
Professor Ram Reddy was a visionary who spoke of equity and social justice, and opening up access to education was his way of addressing the issue of distributive justice and of reaching the unreached.
His ideas, which actually laid the base of a different dimension of education in this country, the way IGNU has been able to reach by transcending time and boundaries and geography, I believe is extraordinarily impressive.
IGNU's success story is a testimony to his vision and commitment. Apart from being a renowned architect of distance education in India, he also held many other notable positions and contributed greatly to the higher education system of the country. He served as the chairman of the University Grants Commission from 1990 to 1995 and later became the chairman of the Indian Council of Social Science Research. He also worked as a key person in the establishment of the National Assessment and Accreditation Council, that is NAAC, to promote quality assurance in higher education in India. Apart from being a scholar, an educationist and a visionary, he was a liberal man who always advocated for equality and social justice. He was immensely proud of his country and its achievements. He was determined to uplift the status of the masses by making higher education accessible to one and all. This was his way to address the issue of social inequality and injustice. Professor G. Ram Reddy was also an affectionate and a down-to-earth human being who derives pleasure from simple things of life. He was a loving family man, a great friend and a colleague to some, while an excellent teacher and a guide to others. He was witty, fun-loving and had a great sense of humor. He also had a keen interest in Indian culture and literature. He was a noble soul who left an indelible impression on the minds of all those who either came in contact with him or were influenced by his innovative ideas, sense of justice, commitment to his job, dedication and selfless service to the country.
We all have to work together to have the flag of IGNU high by remembering the great visionary leader, Professor G. Ram Reddy.
Thank you, MPC, for showing such an inspirational film. We are all emotional at this point.
अब मैं हमारे विश्वविद्यालय के माननीय कुलपति प्रोफेसर नागेश्वर राव सर से उनके वक्तव्य हेतु विनम्र निवेदन करता हूँ.
Honorable Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh, Minister of State for External Affairs and Education, Government of India. Srimati Pramila Reddy Ji. Sri Jammu Krishna Shastri Ji, Chairperson, Indian Language Committee. Avinash Chandra Pandey, Director, IUCCR. Distinguished guests. And my own colleagues. It is a momentous occasion for all of us to remember our great visionary, Professor G. Ram Reddy, the person who showed us the way, the person who told us what is open and distance learning. The person who explained us the concept of access, the concept of equity, and the concept of quality, and how all the three they can be integrated for an affordable education system, which is the need of the hour all over the globe. The message has spread. The old concept of correspondence course, it was being renamed, reviewed, and got the right shape of open and distance learning. Maybe we may use the print material, we may go for face-to-face counseling, we may go for offline examination. Alternatively, we may provide the soft copy of material, reaching to the learners through alternative modes, the channels, the digital tools to reach the people, and online proctored examination. And when we look at this entire transition from 1981 to 2022, it only talks about the open and distance learning. And that is the vision which Professor Ram Reddy has given to all of us. We all are moving ahead. We had a small numbers in the beginning. The numbers grew. And now every year we admit 13 lakh learners, fresh learners. The cumulative student strength is 35 lakhs. We had 36 lakh alumni also. And our age is 36 years. So we see that during the short span of time, we moved in all corners of the country and outside the country also. Wherever we see in the field of education, we find that the learners from IGNU, they are present over here. It is an honor for me to be present over here on this occasion and express my sense of gratitude to a person who built all the big institutions of this country, including this IGNU. I heartily welcome Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh Ji, the person is very kind, very humble, down to earth. And when I met him for the first time, he told me about his journey to IGNU. He came to IGNU 20 years back. And today itself, he was sharing his memories. He is also from our own family. It's a great welcome to a person who is now leading the nation in the field of education as well as in the field of external affairs. We owe a lot to him, especially in the field of external affairs. We are honored to have his blessings, especially the IGNU's footsteps in outside India. Firstly, I must thank him for giving us an opportunity to join E Vidya Bharati. And from this session, July 2022, we are being permitted to go for E Vidya Bharati reach to 19 countries through the Ministry of External Affairs. Around 40 programs, they are being put in that connect, wherein we are reaching to the learners of these 19 countries. It is a tripartite agreement wherein IGNU, Ministry of External Affairs, and TCIL, we are working together to reach to those areas at an affordable cost, because here the scholarships are being provided by the Government of India. In the second area, where his contribution is immense, that we do have a stringent process of recognizing overseas study centers. The process has been simplified. 6 months back, with the result, our movement to all parts of the globe, it has substantially increased. And I must share with great honor that yesterday itself, three institutions from three different countries, they came to IGNU and have their MOU with us, which are pending for the last 3 to 4 years. But because of the process which the ministry has laid for us, now we can do the things at a much faster pace. They are present over here. I also request them to stand when their names, they are being called. The first institution, Klasma International Education and Research Center, PMS Academy Private Limited, Singapore. Yesterday they came and they are here. Unigrad Educational Center, Manama, Kingdom of Bahrain. Wisdom Educational Consultant, Abu Dhabi. I think he could not come. So these three institutions, they came physically to see the Honorable Minister also. And they sought his blessings to move ahead, to reach to these three different countries through our study centers. We are also reaching international arena by going with online programs. By this time, we are having 37 online programs. And the number of enrollments, they are continuously increasing. The online programs, they are in the field of management, in the field of the social sciences, in the field of the languages also. Basically, we launched the MA Jyotish, MA Sanskrit, and MA Ved to reach internationally. And from this year, we are also going to launch the MA Sanskrit internationally through online programs, because the statutorily there is a restriction that one batch of that program it must pass out, then only we can launch these online programs. MBA is on online, PCOM is online, PCA is online, MCA is online, tourism is also online. So we see that the social work courses, they're also online. So we see that the number of courses, they have been put online. Even the Hindi, which has got the international reach, that is also being put on online program. We had recently discussing with Indian Council of Cultural Relations to reach internationally, that how the spread of Indian culture, Indian traditions, Indian language, it may also reach to other countries of the world. And sooner, there will be an MOU, and through that, we can also reach to the people who are outside the country. They are our Indian diaspora. And to them, we would like to supplement the languages, basically. And again, this language support, it will be provided to those people who want to come to India. They are the foreign citizens, but they want to come to India, and for that, they must have the basic knowledge of the Indian languages and Indian culture. So for that acquaintance also, we are moving ahead in that direction. Only yesterday itself, we were invited by the Ministry of Cooperatives. And they have given us a big target, to reach 5 crore cooperative people. We readily agreed, yes, we can do it. The reach is our USP. The access is our USP. We can reach to any corners of the country. And that is why we also accepted a program wherein 15 lakh teachers in higher education, that we made aware with the basics of national education policy. The proposal is already completed, and we are going to launch this on any day. Professor Panda is present over here. We have prepared this structure in such a way that it is cost effective, and the reach to all the teachers, it will become much, much easier. So the numbers for us, that is again the basics which have been given to us by our founder Vice Chancellor, Professor G. Ramareddy ji. We are also in touch with the defense personnel, Army, Navy, and Air Force. Recently, we are having the proposals cleared from the UGC, AICT, as well as ministry to have undergraduate programs wherein the prior learning and the current learning of those people who are serving in all these three forces, Air Force, the Army and Navy, they can complete their undergraduate programs, wherein the knowledge and the skills both are being integrated. And from July session, the Air Force program, already they are going to have an MOU within the next week to see that how the learners from the defense forces, they can join us. This particular initiative is also helpful to the Agniveers, because there they do have a employment period of 4 years. And our undergraduate program is also of 3 years. So we see that, how that can be linked together, and we already linked that program to the requirements of those learners. We are trying to see almost all the areas wherever IGNU can reach: agriculture, tourism, skill orientation. All our programs, undergraduate programs, they were revised. MBA program is revised. MCA program is revised. BCA program is revised. Tourism programs, they were revised. We are also entering in a big way through our SWAYAM courses. More than 150 SWAYAM courses we have launched. And most of our institutions, around 150 universities of the country, they have adopted our SWAYAM courses, so that the credit transfer of those courses, it can easily be feasible. Academic bank of credit, for which the accounts of individual students, they are to be opened to put the academic credentials in their account. For that, we have done a great job. We have received the communication only 1.5 months back. And out of 32 lakh learners whose accounts were open till this point of time, 21 lakh learners, they are from IGNU. So wherever we are being given an opportunity to contribute, we all are contributing immensely. Even in the field of translation, we are trying that our programs, which are very, very popular, we want to get them translated into the regional languages. Journalism is one of the PG program where we are going to launch it from July in Tamil language also, along with Hindi. We had also done one more initiative wherein the Swayamprabha channels, We are the national coordinator of Swayamprabha channel as well as Swayam also. Swayamprabha channels, from 6th of January, we have gone there to teach the subjects, the undergraduate subjects, especially in the field of social sciences, in mother tongue. That is sociology, first year courses. They are being taught in Hindi, Urdu, Punjabi, Telugu, Tamil, Marathi, Malayalam, Gujarati, 12 languages, and for which regular sessions are going on. And by this time, we have completed around 1,500 lectures, 150 lectures for each of these languages, for almost all the social science subjects. We are almost having PG programs in all the disciplines. This is all because of the vision which we inherited from our founder and earlier vice chancellors. We have also received the valuable support from the Ministry of Education. Minister of Education and also the Ministry of External Affairs. It's a proud moment for me to see our honorable guest, who is a member of our family also, who has got great concern for us. When I met him for the first time, he immediately offered to have building in Northeast. And for that, he asked the proposal. Rather than I have to submit the proposal, he said that submit the proposal, I will process it. That is his great concern about IGNU. With these words, I thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, our Vice Chancellor, sir, not only for setting the tone for today's lecture, but also for taking forward the legacy of Professor G. Ramareddy. Under your able guidance, sir, we are reaching new heights every day. We are very proud to have you, sir. May I take this opportunity, Chief Guest, sir, to request you to launch internationally two PG diploma programs, which are offered by the School of Journalism and New Media Studies. Dr. Arul Selvam, can you please come up the stage? The programs are PG Diploma in Development Communication, and the other is PG Diploma in Digital Media. Sir, I request you to do the honors, please.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. As we all know, to deliver today much awaited lecture on Indian education system in the journey of 75 years of India's independence, we have an illustrious personality, Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs and Education, Government of India, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh, a distinguished academician, a noted politician, and a dedicated custodian of natural heritage. May I now invite you, sir, for your lecture, please?
Namaskar. Esteemed Vice Chancellor of IGNU, Professor Nageswar Rao Ji, Srimati Pramila Reddy Ji, spouse of late Professor G. Rama Reddy Ji, Professor Vice Chancellors, Pro Vice Chancellors, distinguished members of the IGNU, and specifically Shastri Ji. Namaskar, aapko. Distinguished member of the IGNU faculty, officials and staff who are present here in the hall and in the 67 regional centers and other who are watching this program live through television channels and social media platforms, and more specifically, our foreign friends who have an MOU yesterday. Ladies and gentlemen, namaskar. It is a great pleasure and privilege for me to deliver the 27th G. Rama Reddy Memorial Lecture. I do not have the privilege of meeting Professor G. Rama Reddy personally, but heard about him as a great visionary and institution builder whose contribution to the open and distance learning in the country is immense. It is a real tribute to the original vision and work of Professor G. Rama Reddy as the founder Vice Chancellor of the university and all others who have contributed that the university has grown into the largest university in the world with 3.5 million students on roll and strong backing of 3.9 million alumni community. Congratulations to IGNU. The university has made tremendous progress in the short span of 36 years of its existence, excelling in both ODL and online education with the mandate of equity, accessibility, quality, and affordability. With 281 programs on offer at all levels, certificates, diploma, and degree from 21 schools of studies covering 42 disciplines, the university has been able to fulfill the aspirations of the millions of learners in the country and abroad. I am happy to note that, recognizing its effort, the NAIC has awarded A++ grade to the university in the very first cycle of accreditations. I congratulate all the stakeholders, students, teachers, academic, and other staff of IGNU headquarters, regional centers, and study centers in India and abroad for this great accomplishment. Education is not just about giving degrees. It is about generating knowledge, minimizing the social gap, and making good human beings with skill and expertise and enlightened citizens of the country. So, today, on this special day, I would like to remind all of us of our journey of education in the last 75 years of India's independence as we celebrate the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. If we reflect on the development of education system in the country over the years, it will help us in planning what we have to do, and let us not think for what we cannot do. If we look back to our civilizations, the education system in the country in ancient times was culturally and spiritually enriched and advanced. Ancient India was the land of inventions and innovations, and we had Takshashila and Nalanda as the world's center of learning or educations. These ancient education systems were oriented towards the all-round development of students, focusing on practical knowledge rather than theoretical knowledge. The first educational policy formulation in 1968 called for compulsory education for all up to the age of 14, outlined the three language formula as the secondary level, at the secondary level, and emphasized on learning of regional languages. The national policy on education formulated in 1986 emphasizes the removal of disparities and equalizing educational opportunity and opened the door for the rural university model. Following the philosophy of Mahatma Gandhi to encourage socio-economic development in the rural areas that are at the grassroots level. Even Indira Gandhi National Open University was established during this period. The 1986 policy was modified in 1992 based on the recommendations of the National Policy of Education 1986. Several new schemes like the Teachers Education Scheme 1987, District Primary Education Program 1994, Mid-Day Meal Scheme 1995, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan 2001, etc. were listed. The National Education Policy 2020, under the visionary leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, and also a very active and dynamic Cabinet Minister Sri Dharmendra Pradhan ji, is seen as a game changer to overhaul the country's education system by reorienting, redesigning, and relinking its processes and outcomes. It is here that IGNU should strengthen its approaches to education in tune with advancement of science and technology. The 75 years of India's independence, India has emerged as having one of the largest higher education systems in the world, with thousands plus universities, 42,000 plus colleges, 11,000 plus STEM alone institutions with advanced state-of-the-art amenities, the top-touch institutions imparting high standards of education, for example, IISc, Bangalore, IITs, IIMs, NITs, IISERS, and central universities, feature in the list of the world's top-ranking institutions and have made India one of the favorite education hubs for the higher studies. In this journey of reforming India's higher education, contribution of IGNU as one of the major players is highly commendable. The basket of courses offered by IGNU provides ample opportunity for an individual's professional growth and skill education. Decades earlier, in distance education, majority of enrolled learners were from in-service. However, IGNU should get analyzed the profile of its students since its inception to see whether enrollment figures of younger age group have increased steadily. Over the period, IGNU has earned the status of the first choice university for students, especially from disadvantaged sections of the society. One of the key aspects of the NEP 2020 is a holistic and multidisciplinary approach with an aim to develop quality citizens. This call for flexible and innovative curricula from higher education institutions, disengaging from the traditional compartmentalized and specialized system of academic thought, a collaborative approach in education by combining different streams of learning such as science, art, and commerce is the need of the hour. Higher education institutions need to embrace a more multifaceted, multi-strata, integrative, and synthesized approach. The Indian education systems needs to be geared towards the holistic development of individual to create overall well-being in society. We have a rich heritage of art, culture, languages, traditions, knowledge, and value system. This need to be imbibed in the curriculum at all levels. Further, for addressing the requirement of holistic education, it is also important that interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary and redesigning the existing program on offer at all levels to in science, social science, humanities, management, technology, etc. I am happy to know that IGNU has already initiated and developed some of the programs with an interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary, and holistic approach and plan to convert gradually all the programs on offer in a phased manner. In the long run, this will ensure the unity and integrity of all knowledge system, respecting the spirit of Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat. NEP 2020 includes system to promote Indian languages, including Sanskrit and also foreign languages. Effective implementation of NEP 2020 in higher education can be possible only when we plan in line with its implementation at the secondary school level. IGNU should take lead in the promotion of regional languages, art and culture, and reach other regions by offering different courses. I am glad to know that IGNU has already initiated courses in major Indian languages at undergraduate level. By establishing the Center of Modern Indian Languages, other than that, looking into the importance of other foreign languages in one's career growth, IGNU has rightly introduced some foreign language program and plan to integrate the courses as a part of any of the suitable programs of the university. This is bound to strengthen the international reach of the IGNU program. Another major focus area of NEP 2020 is multilingualism and teaching in the mother tongue. Language is seen as one of the barriers in imparting education, and the promotion of regional languages may go a long way in increasing the gross enrollment rate. IGNU, being a national university, should tap this opportunity. The university, therefore, needs to get into action in translating its existing courses into regional languages in a phased manner. The academic programs will certainly be more comprehensible if they reach learners in their own mother tongue. I am happy to know that IGNU has already started working in this direction, and I appreciate the recent initiative of IGNU offering online live classes in 12 regional languages covering different programs of social science through the 4 Swayamprabha channels assigned to the university. This needs to be further extended to cover other scheduled languages of the country. I am sure fast implementation strategies of IGNU in this direction will greatly facilitate in achieving National Education Policy 2020 goal. In the arena of skill education, NEP 2020 has made recommendations for integrating skill education into higher education so that an integrated national skill qualification framework can be developed to meet the challenges of skilled workers needed for the country in the 21st century. I am pleased to know that IGNU has signed a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship to play the role of a knowledge partner in the World Bank-sponsored SunClub project for making an assessment of gaps in our Skill India mission implemented at the district level. This is further to be supplemented by providing appropriate training to the grassroots levels officers to overcome those deficiencies. Initiatives of IGNU in reaching out to ITIs, JSS, and PMKKS to create access to higher education for students enrolled in vocational streams is going to yield a great positive result. I have great hope that IGNU will contribute substantially for making the Skill India mission successfully. The recent initiatives of IGNU in designing undergraduate programs for defense personnel, including the Agnivir, has received appreciation from every corner of the country. In this context, I would like to share my opinion is that Agnivirs, for joining by the youths at least 5 years in the defense sector, it will inculcate the patriotism and also dedicated for the nation building. And this is a good and very needs of the hour in our country. For the first time, skill education training has been integrated into general higher education with 50:50 ratio for the award of an undergraduate degree. Further, as there is a provision for multiple entry and exit as per guideline given under our NEP 2020, this will act as a game changer because the country will be benefited by getting strong contingent of educated skilled workforce in both defense and civilian sector. As we know that the Digital India campaign is helping to transform the entire nation into a digitally empowered society and knowledge economy, the disruptions in education during COVID-19 pandemic highlighted the urgent needs to adopt education technology by institutions at all levels. The ICT initiatives in higher education by the Ministry of Education, like the National Mission on Education through ICT, Swayam online courses, Swayam Parbha, DTI channels, Virtual Lab, National Digital Library of India, ESOT, Siddhu, Samrat, etc., have been able to address the need for online access to digital content, especially journals and e-books, online services, e-governance, and accelerating hands-on digital learning ecosystem. National Education Policy 2020 has laid special emphasis on the use of technology in the teaching learning process. The policy recommends existing e-learning platforms such as Swayam, Diksha, etc. to be extended to provide teachers with an online teaching platform and tools, developing engaging e-content, including games, simulation, augmented reality, virtual reality, etc. And extending virtual lab by leveraging existing e-learning platforms such as Diksha, Swayam, and Swayam Parbha with the state-of-the-art technological infrastructure available. IGNU has great potential of converting its ongoing program into online mode and gradually moving towards digital university framework as a major contributor. Perhaps our Vice Chancellor is remembering that in one of the meeting, the Education Mantralaya has already requested the IGNU to initiate the digital university of the country. IGNU is rightly making effort to transform the country into digitally empowered knowledge society with online educational initiative using ICT. Major initiatives of IGNU like e-Gayan course, digital repository of learning resources, e-content app, 38 online programs, around 187 SWAYAM online courses, online counseling, online grievance redressal, online examination system, online question paper delivery system, instant delivery of degree through blockchain technology, use of SWAYAM or smart Samrat portal for the admission and other e-governance services and training of 15 lakh teachers, etc. Deserve prize for this, and I am hopeful that this initiative of IGNU will play a significant role lead in digitizing the entire higher education system of the country. It is expected that IGNU will gradually move towards digital education mode, which requires the faculty, academic, and other staff involved in developing and delivering online courses to be adopted. In the latest technology tools, platforms, and processes, this requires the university to provide regular capacity building programs in digital pedagogy, instructional designs, and the latest technology tools and platforms. I am happy to note that IGNU has recently been identified as one of the UGC recognized capacity development center housed in Stride. The center needs to focus on regular training programs in the latest tools and technology for the development and delivery of online programs. It is pleasing to note that as a part of the international collaborations and in implementation of internationalization of education under NEP 2020, IGNU has already reached 27 countries through its Pan-African e-network project of the Ministry of External Affairs. It is interesting to note that IGNU already has a cumulative enrollment of more than 81,000 overseas students enrolled in 23 overseas study centers spread over 14 countries. Thus, IGNU is already geared towards international outreach in line with NEP 2020. I truly appreciate the recent initiative of establishing overseas studies center at Guyana Online Academy of Learning. Having more than 1,100 Government of Guyana scholarship holders enrolled in different courses. It is also deserved praise that from July 2022, session onward, IGNU is joining the eVidya Bharati project of the Ministry of External Affairs with around 50 programs on offer for students of 19 African countries. IGNU should continue to expand its reach to countries across the globe through ODL and online mode of education. In this context, I would like to share some of the opinion expressed by day before yesterday when I was in Philippines. The Indian diaspora in Philippines, they expressed their desire to have a center in Philippines about the IGNU. So I also feel that the IGNU's expansion and provision to the foreign country, particularly to the Indian diaspora, this will create linking and relinking with the ideas and ethos of our country. And that's feedback is that, because of that, the foreign direct funding is dreaming of our Prime Minister is increasing with the support of our, our diaspora in different country. So I request IGNU especially for the Philippines, if possible. The open system of education followed by IGNU can easily implement the new system of academic bank credit and thus providing maximum opportunities for learners' mobility. I am happy to know that the university has already implemented course-wise registration and has registered more than 20 lakhs learners on the ABC portal. This will surely empower the learners to a great extent, providing mobility through the flexibility credit transfer policy. Developing curriculum taking into account local issues should be encouraged. Here in this, I would like to share another of experience which I come across when I reach out to one of the university in northeastern India, that multidisciplinary and the multidisciplinary different layers in a regional issue, Dibrugarh University, they have a special center called Study of Brahmaputra, the river Brahmaputra. Now it is, of course, the Assam is famous for flood. So by that multidisciplinary approach, study center in Dibrugarh, what they are doing, along the riverine courses of the Brahmaputra, different sections of the population with their indigenous knowledge, with their folk knowledge, with their traditional customs and others, along with the scientific application of geomorphology and also the river flow and current and the ecosystem of the whole riverine system with the existing culture, varied culture of that river basin. And this is one of the best example of multidisciplinary and culmination of different discipline in one river basin. And like that, in different part of our country, many rivers are there. We should have a multidisciplinary discipline subject based on that river system also. One of the major focus area of the NEP is equitable, inclusive education. And in implementation of the IGNU already has a presence of each and every remote corner of the country, including the Northeast. I discussed with our Honorable Vice Chancellor before this function. You know, the Northeastern India is a heterogeneity of landscape, and the landscape is not feasible to link with the surface, each and every villages, and also the mountain ranges. We cannot provide the common education facilities. So through IGNU, with the satellite system and the online system, and the best quality and best e-content, at the same time, the equity has to be reached to such kind of geographical difficulties areas. So I appreciate the approach of the IGNU on this, providing the facilities to others. And also interesting to know that even in the ZEL across the India with 163 special learner support center for ZEL inmates. And so IGNU again provide in our education system to those the ZEL inmate in a process of the rectifications of their activities to the positive sides. It provides a good scope to our ZEL inmates also. IGNU can consider starting new initiative like one graduate in every village. At least in, of course, in the metropolitan cities, many graduate in one family may be there. In the far-flung areas of the country, even the school is not there. So today we are honoring Professor G. Rama Reddy Ji. I was just informed by his daughter that He himself is originated from the village, and then after that he reached to the town. So there are many villages in the country, still we do not have the proper education and proper facilities. So under this new education policy or National Education Policy 2020, we are trying to provide equity, affordability, and the quality also. So under this condition, IGNU has to play a greater role, even in the lower class, not in the higher the education. If possible, please think on the lower courses also. In this way, gross enrollment can be increased, and it will take care of the education of the socio-economically disadvantaged group, especially residing in remote areas where other institutions cannot reach. Also, skill development programs suitable to the local requirement could be identified and offered by IGNU, and rural students could be encouraged to enroll. Coming to the commercialization of education is one of the mandates of the National Education Policy 2020. The policy recommends that private philanthropic investments should be encouraged in the education sector. The idea is to provide lifelong learning opportunity to all sections of our society. This is also the mandate given in the Sustainable Development Goal of the United Nations SDG 4. In 2030, we have to achieve this goal. IGNU is expected to play a lead role by providing lifelong learning opportunities to all the affordable, to all at affordable cost. Fee charges by IGNU is already, I thought, affordable. And there is also a provision for fee exemption for marginalized sectors, particularly SC and ST. This initiative is commendable and need to continue. Integrating sustainable development goal in tune with the NEP 2020 is highly needed for a sustainable India. As we know, sustainable development goal with 17 goals and 169 targets are to be achieved by 2030. Here, I would like to request IGNU to play a key role in creating awareness among different stakeholders about SDG and India's achievement in meeting these targets. I had the privilege to launch the postgraduate diploma in sustainability science for international learners of your university last year. NEP 2020 promotes multidisciplinary education, a flexible learning path, and learner-centric pedagogy. IGNU is the only university in India that can give education on SDG goals to all the stakeholders, from common men to policy makers. I am told that your campus at headquarters is practicing a sustainable approach to campus development plan, equipped with rainwater harvesting units using solar power, lighting system, reuse of water through wastewater treatment plant, etc. These are the SDG goals, and also our Prime Minister is repeatedly appealed to all the citizens of our country and to us also. Say, for example, in the international level, our Prime Minister is champion in Solar Alliance and keeping our Indian's philosophy that the whole family, whole world is one family, that is our Vasudeva Kutumbakam. And with that ideology, with that philosophy, our Prime Minister is trying to implement through this NEP. And the same thing, IGNU is transforming into practice. That is very encourageable. IGNU should incorporate its own such initiative in relevant courses to inspire and motivate the learners. Such initiative could also be extended through the regional centers, network of the university. At the end, I would like to say that we have high hope from IGNU, as it has to be contribute significantly in the field of mass education, having substantial impact on the gross enrollment ratio, leading in inclusive education and equitable society. This is exactly that Professor G. Ram Reddy had visualized for IGNU to strive for nation building. In coming times, IGNU should strengthen digital learning initiatives, register more and more students in the academic bank of credit, involve its alumni in the design and delivery of quality courses, provide courses as per market demand, and equip students with 21st century skill for better job opportunity. Also, IGNU should expand its international reach by introducing innovative courses tailor-made for the Indian diaspora, as I requested earlier, as well as for the international learners. As a Minister of State of External Affairs and Education, I will be glad to extend support to your endeavor in this direction. I express my heartfelt thank to Professor Nageser Rauji and his dynamic team to be part of this significant occasion for delivering the Professor G. Ram Reddy Memorial Lecture. My best wishes to each and every member of the IGNU fraternity for good health, happiness, and prosperity. Thank you all. Jai Hind.
Once a teacher, always a teacher. I believe that is true, sir. We have enjoyed every bit of your lecture, sir. Your valuable insights on New Education Policy 2020 and role of IGNU in providing an education which has equity, access, affordability, and quality. We'll always remember, sir. You have aptly explained that education is not just about giving degrees. It is about generating knowledge, minimizing the social gaps, and making good human beings with skills and expertise as enlightened citizens of the country. Thank you, sir. Thank you once again for the very insightful session and your gracious presence. As we all know, that no event can be organized and realized without the efforts of a team of dedicated people. Few are seen, and few work tirelessly behind the scenes. At this juncture, to acknowledge all the hard work, may I now request our registrar, Dr. Alok Chaube, to pay a vote of thanks, please.
Manch par upasthit. आज के मुख्य अतिथि ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स एंड हायर एजुकेशन डॉक्टर राजकुमार रंजन सिंह जी इग्नो के आदरणीय कुलपति प्रोफेसर नागेश्वर राव जी मंच पर उपस्थित श्रीमती प्रोमिला रेड्डी जी मंच पर उपस्थित प्रो वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर महापात्रा, प्रोफेसर सत्यकाम जी, आज के इस गैदरिंग में उपस्थित सभी प्रो वाइस चांसलर्स, डायरेक्टर्स, फैकल्टी, फैकल्टी स्टाफ, नॉन टीचिंग ऑफिशियल्स, नॉन टीचिंग स्टाफ और हमारे रीजनल सेंटर्स से भी जो हमारे ऑफिशियल्स आज के इस प्रसारण में जुड़े हुए हैं, सर्वप्रथम मैं मुझे आभार व्यक्त करने का जो एक सम्मान और गौरव दिया गया है, इसके लिए मैं अपनी ओर से व्यक्तिगत रूप से इग्नो को आभार जरूर व्यक्त कर दूं कि आप सभी ने मुझे अपनी ओर से यहाँ इस फंक्शन को सफल बनाने में जिन जिन का योगदान है सभी के लिए आभार व्यक्त करने के लिए का अवसर मुझे दिया। आज के जो मुख्य अतिथि महोदय हैं माननीय मंत्री जी, मैं सर्वप्रथम उनका आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। विशेष रूप से उन्होंने एक बहुत कम समय में हमारा जो निमंत्रण है वो स्वीकार किया और जिस सादगी के साथ, मैं शायद मैं बहुत कम ही मैंने देखा है कि जब भी हमारे मुख्य अतिथि होते हैं, जनरली ये हो देखा जाता है कि जब सभी लोग उपस्थित होते हैं तभी हमारे मुख्य अतिथि आते हैं, लेकिन यहाँ मैं देख के दंग रह गया कि मुख्य अतिथि समय के काफ़ी पूर्व आए। इससे उनका इंटरेस्ट और उनका इग्नो के प्रति जो भाव है वो प्रकट होता है। मैं कई बार एक नहीं शशत नमन करते हुए उनका आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ कि सर आपने यहाँ हमको इस टाइम दिया और आपकी ज्ञान वाणी से हम लोग सभी रोमांचित हुए। मैं आपका बहुत अधिक आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ हमारे माननीय कुलपति जी का, जो हमारे लिए नित नए आदर्श प्रस्तुत करते हैं। मैं बड़ा सरप्राइज़ करता हूँ कि वो कहाँ से इतनी चीज़ों, उनकी मेमोरी रहती है, हम लोग सभी चर्चा करते हैं कि उनकी मेमोरी में इतनी चीज़ें कहाँ से आती हैं। हर बार हमारे लिए एक नया आदर्श और एक नया सबक वो लेके आते हैं और हम लोग सीखने का प्रयास करते हैं। मैं उनका भी आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ कि वो अपने बहुत व्यस्त शेड्यूल में, बीच में लास्ट वीक वो बाहर भी थे, तो भी उन्होंने इस फंक्शन को पूरा ऑर्गेनाइज करने में सभी को अपना मार्गदर्शन दिया और स्वयं ने भी अपनी आशीर्वाणी से हम सबको अनुग्रहित किया। मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ श्रीमती प्रोमिला रेड्डी जी का कि उनकी गरिमामय उपस्थिति से आज के फंक्शन को एक सफलता में और चार चांद लगना, जिसको कहते हैं, वो लगे। जहाँ तक फंक्शन की सफलता की मैं बात करूँगा कि सफल तो देखिए कोई भी फंक्शन अगर हम शेड्यूल के हिसाब से कर लें हो जाता है, लेकिन जब फंक्शन में ऐसी ज्ञान वाणी से हमारा हृदय मन रोमांचित होता है और एक अमिट छाप छूटती है तो उसकी सफलता का अभी परिणाम परिमाण लगा पाना बड़ा कठिन होता है। तो यही मैं कहना चाहूँगा कि आज के इस फंक्शन में मेरी ख्याल में जो शुरू से आज तक का जो जस्ट राइट फ्रॉम द इंसेप्शन ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, जो डेवलपमेंट, जो ग्रोथ हुआ है, उसके बारे में जो हमको जो जानकारी मिली है और जो आगे ग्रोथ हो रही है उसके बारे में जो भी हमको जानकारी मिली है, तो ये फंक्शन की सफलता को हम इससे परिमाण निकाल ही नहीं सकते हैं। फंक्शन की सफलता कई गुना आगे, और कई चीज़ें ऐसी होती हैं, हम एक शिक्षक के रूप में अच्छे से जानते हैं कि हम जब कक्षा लेते हैं तो हम ये मानते हैं कि अगर हमारे 10% बच्चे भी अंतरात्मा से ज्ञान के साथ अगर एथिक्स भी लेके आगे बढ़ते हैं तो शायद एक शिक्षक की बहुत बड़ी सफलता होती है। इसी तरह किसी भी फंक्शन में जब इस तरह की ज्ञान वर्षा होती है और ज्ञान वाणी होती है जो हमारे अंदर उथल पुथल मचाती और परिवर्तन लाती है, तो वो अपने आप में एक बहुत बड़ी सफलता का विषय होता है। मैं आगे हमारे जो इस आज के फंक्शन को ऑर्गेनाइज किया है प्रोफेसर सत्यकाम जी ने और उनकी टीम ने, मैं उनका बिल्कुल तहे दिल से आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ कि उन्होंने एक बहुत अच्छा एक ज्ञान दर्शन हम लोगों को दिया हुआ है आज के फंक्शन के माध्यम से। और आगे मैं प्रोफेसर महापात्रा जी ने जो हमको अपनी आशीर्वाणी से हमको जानकारियाँ दीं, मैं उनका भी बहुत आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। मैं हमारे यहाँ के जो भी विदेश से जो हमारे डेलीगेट्स आए हैं, मैं उनके उपस्थिति होने का भी बहुत आभार व्यक्त करता हूं कि वो हमारे बीच में आए और उन्होंने इस फंक्शन को और गरिमागरी बनाया, ग्लोरीफाई किया, और मैं इसके लिए उनका भी बहुत ज़्यादा आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूं कि जो भी इस फंक्शन के पीछे आगे सामने तो हैं, जिन्होंने भी पीछे से इस फंक्शन को सफल बनाने में अपना योगदान दिया, मैं उनको भी बहुत ज़्यादा उनके प्रति भी अपना आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। और अंत में मैं ये कहता हूँ कि आज के फंक्शन में जो हमारे बीच में चर्चाएँ हुई कि इग्नो का एक्सपांशन अब इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे हो रहा है, मैं भी ये उम्मीद करता हूँ कि हमारे यहाँ का इग्नो का जो है, जैसे हम एक ज़माने में सुनते थे कि साहब ब्रिटिश एम्पायर का रात नहीं होती, अंधेरा नहीं होता, मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ कि इग्नो के माध्यम से भारतीय ज्ञान दर्शन का, ज्ञान वर्षा का भी कभी सूर्यास्त नहीं होगा। हम इतने देशों में हमारे सेंटर होंगे और वो धीरे धीरे विंग्स ले रहे हैं। अभी कल ही शायद बात हुई है कि हम, अभी सर ने फिलीपींस की बात करी, कल बात हो रही थी इंग्लैंड में भी, हम लोग लंदन में कुछ सेंटर खोलने के बारे में चर्चा कर सकते हैं। तो मैं समझता हूँ कि जल्दी वो टाइम आएगा और हम जिस चीज़ के लिए हम कहते हैं कि हम विश्व गुरु बनने की ओर अग्रसर हैं, डेफिनेटली एक दिन ऐसा आएगा कि इग्नो के द्वारा जो ज्ञान वर्षा विश्व के किसी ना किसी कोने में 24 घंटे हो रही होगी, कोई ना कोई यहाँ से लर्निंग ले रहा होगा, कोई ना कोई यहाँ से सीख रहा होगा। और मैं इसी उम्मीद के साथ, इसी आशा के साथ पुनः आप सभी का अपने हृदय से, कोर ऑफ हार्ट से मैं आप सभी का अभिनंदन करता हूँ और मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।
धन्यवाद सर। आप सभी से अनुरोध है कि राष्ट्रगान के सम्मान में कृपया अपने स्थान पर खड़े हो जाएं।
पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा दावण उत्तल गंगा भिन्न हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उत्सल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल गायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।